Hey guys, welcome to SS Unitech. Sushil this side, and this is continuation of Power BI tutorial. So today we are going to see about the cardinality inside the data modeling in the Power BI. So this is very important while we are going to clean up our data, after that build the relationship between the tables. So go to on the Power BI desktop and we'll see in the practical. So here, as you can see, this is a project by which we are currently working on. So the first table, which is our center table, that country sales final table, and we have three dimension tables, that is address, customer and product. Now double click on the relationship between address and country sales final table. So here you can see the left bottom, we have option for cardinality. So here we can see it is by default many to one, and we have other options as well, like one to one, one to many and many to many. So what it means? It means if our first table, that is our country sales final table, is having multiple data against a single entry, and in the second table that would have distinct values. In our case, we can see the address, we are having the distinct address IDs, and in the country sales final table we are having multiple address IDs. So in this case, the join that will be many to one, because we are having the multiple values in the country sales final table and single value inside the dim address table. So this is many to one. Let's move to next one. If we are having the distinct values in the country sales final table and in the address table, then that relationship will be called as one to one relationship. So there will not have any duplicate values either country sales final table or address table. In the next, one to many relationship. If we will switch the tables, first table will be the address table and second table will be the country sales final table, then that relationship will be called as one to many relationship. It means our first table will have distinct values and our second table will have multiple values against a single value. So that will be the one to many. In case of many to many relationship, it will have multiple values in the table 2 and in the table 1. So in this case, if we will join between the country sales final table with the country sales final table on the basis of address ID. So address IDs are repeated in the country sales final table. So that will be the many to many relationships. It means we'll have the multiple values in the table 1 and we'll have the multiple values in the table 2 as well. So that relationship will be called as many to many relationship. So I hope you have understand about the cardinality. So this is basically how our tables are gonna join. So thank you so much guys for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. See you in the next video. Thank you so much.